Something big.
Which is?
You can't marry Bryce.
Okay, Kevin?
Have you ever heard of common law? Well, common law states that a man and woman that have been living together for 7 years, like us, and they meet certain conditions, well, they're considered married in the eyes of the law, which would make us husband and wife.
Call him a favor. You're Slinky, I believe.
Thank you.
I'm Kevin.
I'm Jennifer. Welcome to the neighborhood. Hi.
Hi, Jennifer. How much are the cookies?
Cookies are $1. Which cookies do you want?
Okay.
Okay,
let me get
that.
All right. Yeah. Yeah! Living on a dream! Wait, what does it say right there? Right there. What does it say?
International.
That's right. That's right.
I was right.
I believe it. I believe it. I do.
Great speech, Mrs. Valedictorian. You guys ready to go take on the world?
I will settle for a foot massage and an umbrella drink.
Can you guys believe it? We graduated. No more school ever.
Except for Miss Law School. She's got 3 more years.
Now you finally get to channel your hostility into something that will get you paid.
I know.
It's a dream come true.
So what about you, Jen?
You guys, I bought a house.
What?
I bought a house. Are you kidding me? Guys, I did.
Are you joking?
No, I'm serious. You know how I've worked every single job I could get and save every cent for a down payment?
Yeah.
And I got it, you guys. Oh. I got a house, and it's absolutely perfect.
I mean,
congratulations.
Leave it to the CEO of the second grade lunchroom. Ah! Look, I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Hey, Jen, Kev? Great speech.
Thanks, Kev.
So are we still on for Friday?
What's Friday?
Oh, I'm moving out of the dorms. Yeah, some silly rule about needing to be a student to live here.
Oh, ditched out on your final paper again, huh?
Let's just say that's
a work in progress.
Thank you.
Do you guys still have that disease where you finish each other's sentences?
Mm-hmm. Friday works perfectly.
Thanks, Jen. Betsy.
Bye.
Satan. Mm-hmm. Sally.
It's always funny.
He is funny.
Are you seriously gonna let Kevin just move in with you? How's he supposed to pay rent?
Come on. Kevin is great. And charity begins at home, right? Besides, the place needs a paid job, and Kev.
Yeah, I got a couple
in the world.
Said he'd fix the fence.
Oh, Kevin's a hoot, but are you sure that's a good idea?
Yes. I've known Kevin my whole life. He's one of my oldest friends. And it's just gonna be a week or two until he gets on his feet. I mean, come on. What could possibly go wrong? He's great, right? Yes, Mr. Fujimura. The proposal for Crystal Towers is right on schedule. Great, I look forward to your visit. Great, see you next week. Hey, you're up early.
Yeah, big day. I got the CEO of Medtron at 8, I've got the city manager at noon, and I got the VP of First Financial penciled in at 4.
I didn't know your caddy skills were so in demand.
Next week is junior prom. All my coworkers are out getting tuxes. What are you doing? What is this?
Hey, Kevin.
What have I told you about instant coffee? Yuck. A little soy latte, not so much foam. Yeah, almost as good as being in
Venice. One day when I'm not so crazed.
Whatever happened to the girl who used to pretend she was a German exchange student to get free bratwurst?
She got a job.
Stupid jobs.
I'm late. The Japanese backers for Crystal Towers are coming into town next week, and I have a ton of work to do.
Aren't you forgetting something, my dear? I packed an extra fruit roll, dolphin-safe tuna, extra pickles, no mayo, just the way you like it.
You're the best.
Yeah.
Have a good day.
You too.
See you, Napoleon. Enjoy your day.
You want breakfast? Do you want breakfast? Get over here. Let's go get breakfast.
So, with the restructuring outlined in the proposal, our plan will give downtown a whole new vision and stay well within your price range.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Enjoy your day. Thank you.
Jennifer.
Oh, hi.
Great work.
Thank you, Mr. Monroy. Really, thank you.
You pull one of your slam dunks with Fujimura? We could be talking corner office.
Great work.
You.
I guess you played your cards right. Hello. What are you doing this side of town anyway?
I was in the neighborhood scoping out our firm's new offices, and I thought I'd swing by. I hope you're ready to dance those beautiful feet off tonight.
I suppose that sounds good. It does. Oh, and Kevin was hoping that we could try out one of his new games.
Kevin?
Mm-hmm.
Now, you guys sure are a package deal. My best girl and her long, long, long time roommate.
Oh, it hasn't been that long, right?
Sweetheart, he's lived there 7 years.
He needs a helping hand.
You know I love Kevin, but maybe he needs a nudge out of the nest, get some goals.
He has goals.
A grown man making board games.
Kevin's ship will come in. I know it.
You are the nicest person I've ever met. And that is why I love you so much.
Here is to my one and only. I will see you tonight.
Bye. Afternoon, Janie.
Afternoon.
A little something for you.
Thank you.
What's going on?
Mrs. Von Hoffman just finished having lunch with Mr. Johnson and his family. I heard her say the new partner is going to be Johnson or you.
Mrs. Von Hoffman.
Such a lovely boy, unlike some who have yet to grow up.
Did you hear that I signed a friend on the coast?
Well, you're making all sorts of deals today, aren't you? I'll see you tonight, and bring that delightful girlfriend of yours. Ciao, darling.
Each samurai
fortifies a castle to defend the neighboring village from the other players on the hexagonal grid. What do you think?
Yeah, it's perfect for ages 8 to loser.
Kevin based it on real history. It's neat, huh?
That's fascinating. Sweetie, don't we have a gala to go to?
Can I just fix my contacts first?
Hey, what's that gala that you guys are going to? What's it for?
My firm's just moving into newer offices.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Needed a bigger place for your ego.
Okay. Okay. Okay, ready. Bye, Kev. Good night.
Checkmate. I told you.
Yeah.
Mr. Davis. You remember Jennifer?
Hello. It's nice.
Will you please excuse me for a second?
New Jennifer is quite a catch.
Yes.
Which firm is she with?
She's with Monroe & Klein.
Impressive. She's lovely. Darling, there's something I've been meaning to discuss with you.
Yes, ma'am?
As you know, we are hiring a new partner in July.
I haven't really given much thought.
Of course you haven't. Well, a word to the wise. A young man should be able to play the field, but a partner needs to project stability.
I couldn't agree more. And Jennifer and I have been going out exclusively for 6 months.
Really? I know a certain receptionist who would beg to differ. Now, the choice is between you and Johnson. His numbers aren't as good as yours, but he is a solid family man.
I see.
Now, your Jennifer would make some lucky man a fabulous wife, don't you agree?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Enjoy the party.
I've got to hand it to you. In the past year, you've really pulled your life together. You've got a new job, a great boyfriend. I was starting to worry that Kevin was rubbing off on you.
What? You are so wrong about Kevin. He's one of the smartest people I know. And he's always had my back.
Sweetie, I know that Kevin's your best friend, and he's a puppy dog, but don't you see you're just enabling him?
You would actually be doing him a favor by making him stand on his own 2 feet. You know, tough love.
Come on! So my golden ticket came in today.
Bellamy's interested in my game idea.
That's great news, Kev.
Yeah, we got a meeting on Saturday.
Ah! The game is off. Bar exam's next month, and I've only slept 2 hours this week.
Yeah, well, you have to man up. Tonight's poker night.
I thought you had a date tonight.
Oh, she said, yeah, she canceled. I want to meet somebody nice, not too crazy.
That rules out all your past girlfriends.
Oh, wow.
Hey. I gotta get back to the library.
Oh, come on.
I gotta read up on tarts and contracts.
Is that torts and contracts?
That's exactly why I've gotta read up.
Yeah.
Anyway, we don't all have 3-hour work days, Kev.
Oh, hey, I remind you, I may not pay rent, but that house runs smoothly. It's a win-win.
Maybe. Someday, Jen is gonna move on, and when she does, you gotta get a real job. She's already got Bryce.
Bryce is totally wrong for her, and she'll figure it out soon enough. I know her.
Ah, what a terrific evening. And I thought that you were all tied up with work this week.
Well, what can I say? I had to see you.
I had to see you.
Because I wanted to see if something fit.
See if what fits?
Come here.
Okay.
My grandmother's engagement ring.
Oh, my gosh.
And my grandfather brought this ring from the old country. He carried it across two continents, but he used to say he could carry it to the end of the earth for the woman he loved. And now I know just how he felt.
Are you serious?
Jennifer, what I want to know is, will you marry me?
Yes. Yes, of course. Oh, it's beautiful. It's a little loose, but wow.
I'll get it resized. From here on, everything is going to be perfect.
I gotta check my messages. I'll be right back.
Mm-hmm. Kev, hi. Do you have a minute?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm just going through my game ideas book.
Kev, we need to talk.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, you know how I said that you could stay here until you got on your feet?
Mm-hmm.
But, Kev, that was 7 years ago.
Yeah, I know. Time flies.
Yeah. So there's something that I need to tell you.
Okay.
I have some news.
Yeah?
Bryce proposed.
Bryce proposed? Really? What? Wow! What did he say when you turned him down? He cried, right? Is he crying outside?
No, Kev! I said yes.
What?
Yes!
No.
Yes,
no.
I'm getting married. Look.
No. You can't marry someone after only knowing them for 6 months.
Oh, sure you can. If it's the right person, yes, you can.
No. Jen, I've seen you take longer picking out fridge magnets, okay? Could you just think about this for a second?
I have thought about this. After the wedding, Bryce is gonna be moving in here, so I think it's best that you need to move out.
Oh! Who are you right now? What have you done with Jennifer?
Kevin, this is gonna be a really good thing for you. It will give you a chance to have structure in your life and get a real job.
I have a real job.
And nobody believes in your board games and your caddy more than I do.
Who's gonna take Napoleon to the park? Hmm? Who's gonna feed the fish? You don't even know this guy. I bet you he doesn't even know what your favorite color is. Green. Your scarf is green, your dress is teal, it's a form of green. You love Green Fridays.
Kevin. It's time. It's gonna be a good thing for you. I know it.
Kevin, how many times have I told you about blocking my car? A man's house is his castle. Consider my driveway a piranha-filled moat, okay?
I'm sorry, Mr. Henderson. I'll be more careful.
Kev, you look terrible, kid.
I had a rough night.
You should marry that girl.
Huh?
Mr. Bellamy? Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were somebody else. Bryce?
Kevin, what are you doing here? This isn't your usual hangout.
I swapped. You too, I see.
This is Chandra. Chandra, this is Kevin.
Hi.
Hi.
Why haven't we met before?
Mm.
I thought I knew all of Bryce's friends.
Me too.
Mm-hmm. I'll be right back.
Yeah, Chandra's business colleague. I don't know what you think you saw.
I know what I saw, Bryce.
Listen, Caddy, I'm not serious about Chandra, but I am about Jennifer. We have a future together. Don't you mess that up.
Hi, Kevin.
Mr. Bellamy, I gotta go. Jen, I saw something today.
Yeah, I know. Bryce told me you ran into each other today.
He did?
Yeah. He had a meeting with Chandra. He said he ran into you.
You know about her?
Yeah. She's great. She heads up the Midwest operations.
What? Oh, okay. Okay. Well, brace yourself, okay? Because I hate to have to be the one to tell you this, but she was all over him.
Kevin, is this because you want things to go back to the way they were?
What? No! No! I feel like my brain is about to explode!
Jen?
Yep, there it goes!
Oh, and how are my two favorite people?
Hi.
How's it packing, Kevin? I know it's a bit of a shock, but you're gonna thank us for this one day, okay, buddy? Honey, did I leave my gold cufflinks in the kitchen? I need them for my trip.
Oh, absolutely. I will go get them.
Too bad, Caddy. Your meal ticket's been pulled.
Well, you cheating jerk. You know, if I wasn't schooled in the teachings of the Dalai Lama, I'd wipe that smile right off your two-timing face. What the heck, huh?
Whoa. Hey! I'll get him to stop. Don't make me get my leaf blower, you two.
What are you doing?
Oh, honey.
It's a $2,000 suit. Oh, it bit me.
We'll get inside and we'll get something on it, okay? Kevin.
I got it worse. It tastes like deodorant.
Kevin, that was pathetic.
It's not even funny. It's not even funny, man. Bryce wants a trophy wife. He's totally, utterly wrong for her.
Look, nothing you can do. Why are you really so upset?
Because it's Jen. She's rushing into this. I just feel like this freight train is heading right toward my best friend, and I gotta do something. Only I could just buy a little more time, and she'd see for herself how wrong Bryce is for her. And as her best friend, I have to do everything in my power to protect her.
It's funny. In a lot of states, you'd practically be married yourselves. Common law marriage, anyway.
Wait, what do you mean common law?
Goes back to frontier times when people didn't live close enough to a city to get married by a justice of the peace. Lawmakers knew they had to do something so that people living farther afield could get married, so they decreed that if people lived together a certain period of time, met certain conditions, then the state would step in, make the whole thing legal.
Really?
It's called a common law marriage.
And how is this different than a real marriage?
It is a real marriage. If you've got a common law marriage, in the eyes of the law, you're a husband and wife.
Common law.
Hi, Jen.
Hi, Kev.
What you doing?
Oh, I'm just looking up ideas for the reception.
Hmm.
I've always wanted a gazebo in the backyard, and this place has beautiful ones.
That's nice.
Mm-hmm. So, how's the packing going?
I learned something important today. Something big.
Which is?
You can't marry Bryce.
Okay, Kevin.
Have you ever heard of common law? Hmm? Well, common law states that a man and woman that have been living together for 7 years, like us, and they meet certain conditions, well, they're considered married in the eyes of the law, which would make us husband and wife.
Who told you that?
Oh, Jeremy told me that.
Oh, Jeremy.
Hmm?
Jeremy told you that.
Yeah.
Jeremy, who's passed the bar exam how many times?
Yeah, okay.
Zero.
Fair enough, but Jen?
Okay.
Yeah.
This is ridiculous.
Oh. Okay. This marriage is gonna take a little work.
Coming!
I dropped the kids at daycare and came over as fast as I could. Now, about this little situation.
I feel ridiculous asking, but I had to be absolutely sure.
Don't look so worried, okay?
Okay.
In order for someone to be able to argue that a common law marriage exists, there are some very specific conditions that need to be met.
Okay, so this is all just nonsense, right?
Oh, I'm sure that you have nothing to worry about.
Okay.
So, there are four conditions that must be met.
Four.
Right. Mm-hmm. So, first and foremost, the couple in question needs to be a man and a woman living in a state where common law applies, like here.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Second, they both need to have lived in the same residence for at least 7 years. So you meet both those things.
Mm-hmm.
Relax. So do a million people, okay?
Okay.
It's the last two that are definitely the most important. So during the 7 years, the couple needs to have, at least once, held themselves out as a married couple. And I mean, you never did that, right?
No. No, like introduce him as my husband, like, hi, my name's Jennifer, and this is my husband, Kevin.
Good. Good, that's great. And I mean, you never, like, use the same last name on any public documents.
No. No, I have never.
What is that face?
Well, we took that gruesome Mazatlan, and I might have said that he was my husband so I could get the half-off deal.
Right.
And don't forget the cable account.
And the cable account.
That's only three conditions. The fourth is definitely the most important.
Okay.
So the law specifically states that at least one of the two parties must be able to argue that there was an intention to marry at some point. And the only way to prove that, there must be some sort of public exchanging of vows or the giving of a symbolic gift. And that didn't happen, right?
No, no, that never happened.
Okay.
Hey, what about that ring?
Ow. Ring? What ring? This! What? It's a friendship ring Kevin gave to me. Please, it's not worth anything. His mom made it when she lived in a commune back in the 70s.
So that is a family heirloom and Kevin gave it to you?
What?
Look, Jennifer. This is about an accumulation of evidence, okay? And right now, even Kevin's dolt of a brother could potentially argue that the acceptance of a ring in itself denotes the implied intention of marriage.
So are you telling me that Kevin might actually have a case? That he and I are married?
Yes.
Hey, honey. How's Chicago?
Incredible. It's pure adrenaline with all these movers and shakers.
Bryce, there's something that I need to tell you.
So how'd it go with the caterers this morning?
Actually, something came up. I didn't get a chance to...
Wait, you missed Henri?
I'm sorry, okay? I just didn't get a chance to...
Henri is a personal friend and the best chef in the city. He's doing this as a favor to me.
Bryce, I know. I'm sorry, okay?
It's okay. I'll handle it.
On a lighter note...
Guess who booked the Arboretum?
I know how much you love
it there. I had to pull a few strings, but voila.
Oh, that's great.
I thought you'd be more excited.
No, I am. I am. It's a dream come true, really.
Now, what did you want to tell me?
Nothing. So, how's your flight?
Sweetheart, can I call you back in a few minutes?
Yeah.
All right, bye.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Bruce.
Hi.
Can I buy you guys a drink?
Please. Yeah.
So as you can see from chart 2A in its first stage of construction, we are at an occupancy rate of 89% for Crystal Towers.
Yeah.
Excuse me, just one moment, please. Thank you. I'll be back. Kevin?
Hi.
Hi. What are you doing here?
Well, you're so busy, you know. You kind of took off in a hurry and you forgot your lunch.
Kevin.
Yeah.
I just heard the good news.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
For what?
Well, you too, of course. Jen. I mean, I can't believe you kept this quiet. Hey, by the way, where are you guys registered?
We are not registered. I will tell you all about it later.
Okay.
I'm sorry. I was outside and they were asking me who I was going to come in here and see. And I might have blurted out that...
I was your wife.
I'm sorry, okay? They weren't going to let me in here, Jen. I only told the receptionist and the doorman.
There is no doorman in this building.
Nice guy. Asian man.
That is Mr. Fujimura, my biggest client. Okay. Yep, great, thank you. Can you believe it? Me and Kevin, a couple. I mean, have you ever heard anything so absurd?
No, but as your legal counsel, I'm gonna need all of the facts, you know? Tell me you guys were never romantic. Please.
With Kevin?
Yeah.
No, are you crazy?
Some women might fall for his whole hopeless teddy bear thing.
Yes. Okay, good. I like that. Okay.
Ooh, I like that. The offering? Peace offering?
Nice. Let's see the pacifist.
That's peaceful.
Hey, Jen, we were just taking pictures for the warrior cards in the game.
So you're the one that put Kevin up to all this, huh? And you consider yourself a lawyer?
Well, I'm hoping to go into environmental law, so.
You wouldn't know a real lawyer if she walked up and she bit you.
Kevin, you me, outside.
What?
That stunt you pulled at my office today was completely out of line.
I was bringing you lunch. I was trying to be helpful. I was trying to show you that a husband can share the load.
Oh, you want to share the load? Then deal with this. I'm supposed to meet my Japanese finances for dinner tonight, and since you introduced yourself as my husband, now they want us both to come celebrate.
Oh. Yeah, that's my bad.
Kevin should be here any moment.
Hi, I'm just here.
Oh, there he is now. Will you excuse me just a moment?
Please. Hi.
Okay, so do what we rehearsed.
Yes.
You're only gonna be here a few minutes, and then you're just gonna go, okay?
Relax. Madame?
No.
Okay, no French, got it.
No French.
We up here? Ah, please.
Mr. Fujimura, this is my... Kevin.
Ah, yoroshiku. We are most honored to formally meet the new husband of Jennifer. Well, we congratulate you. Oh. Please, sit down. Everyone, please.
Thank you. I can do it.
Okay. Okay. Gotcha.
Can I offer you some wine?
Yes, please.
May I ask, what kind of work you do, Mr. Kevin?
Well, I am currently active in the recreational services industry. Specifically, the golf sector. And I mean that I think of my best ideas on the golf course. Yeah. Enough about me, though, huh? Let's toast to your new venture.
Excellent. We are most excited to move forward. However, there is a small complication that has risen with the board. My co-workers informed me that several of the zoning permits are still outstanding in this project.
If I may,
okay, got this.
Let me tell you a little story about Jennifer here. A couple years back, our garbage cans kept getting knocked over in the middle of the night, every night. Did a little investigating. Turns out we had a big family of raccoons that had moved in underneath our house. And since it was like Thanksgiving weekend, the animal control guy couldn't do a darn thing about it.
Where's the waiter?
We had 20 people coming over for dinner. Jen here wouldn't take no for an answer. So with just an address book and a dying cell phone, bam, in 30 minutes flat, she had the deputy mayor himself crawling around underneath our house with a flashlight. Problem solved. And now, the point of this story is that Jennifer here, there is nothing that she can't accomplish or achieve. She says she's gonna get you those permits. Well, by golly, she's gonna do it.
I shall relay that to the board.
That's great. Wow. You know we don't really know each other, but I think we all have something in common here. We all think Jennifer here is just pretty darn amazing. Right? Huh? Come by. Woo! Yeah! Get in there. Hey, Jennifer.
Sally. I can't believe it.
Is it horrible? It's horrible. Is it terrible?
No. Kevin actually, he's been amazing. He pulled this whole thing off, and he even saved the day.
That is definitely not what I thought you'd say.
I know.
How long did he stick around?
He's still here. He's at the table.
Wait, you left Kevin alone at a table with your most important client?
And now, the musical stylings is Kevin the Duncan.
I have to go.
Yeah. Okay, bye.
This is the captain of the Pinafore.
Kevin.
Yeah.
This is not a karaoke bar.
Oh, yes, it is.
For the HMS Pinafore, yes, it is.
I'm totally going to lose my job, Mr. Fujimura. I am so sorry. This whole thing is
I know this song. That's how I learn English. Ooh.
I am the captain of the Pinafore and a right good captain, too. You're very, very good, and be it understood, I command a right good crew. We're very, very good, and be it understood, he commands a right good crew. Though related to a peer, I can hand reef a steer and ship a salvagee. I am never known to quail at the fury of a gale, and I'm never, never sick at sea.
What, never?
No, never.
What, never?
Well, hardly ever.
Hardly ever sick at sea.
Then
give him three cheers and I want to cheer more for the hardy captain of the Pinafore. Then give him three cheers and I want to cheer more for the captain of the Pinafore.
Fantastic.
Triple threat. Right?
Yes. Fujimura, everybody.
I mean, who knew Mr. Fujimura could sing?
I know. He's a triple threat. I mean, he can sing, he can dance, his origami cranes. Terrific. I think he had a good time. He said next time he visits, he's bringing his wife Michiko and the kids.
I don't know what to say to you right now.
Was that a laugh?
Oh, no, I'm still very angry at you. No. You did good. It really was an unforgettable evening, so thank you, Kev.
Oh, it's not over yet.
What do you mean? What the, Kevin?
Surprise!
Behold, the wedding reception we've never had.
Yeah!
Woohoo!
Yeah!
Yeah.
I must admit, you throw a great party for a dead man.
Thank you.
Mr. Henderson, I am so sorry. Are we being too loud?
For years, I've been saying these two characters ought to get hitched, and now you have, you sly monkeys.
Thank you, but
would you please try to get Kevin to stop blocking my driveway with his car? That way I won't be over here banging on your door all the time.
Will do.
All right. Partay.
Move your car.
I know. I'm sorry. Sorry about that. Babe, you here?
Bryce? You're back early.
Yes, you'd know that if you checked your messages.
I'm sorry, okay? Everything has been extremely crazy.
And so I see. Congratulations, newlyweds. Did Kevin finally snap and send away for a mail order bride?
Yeah.
Actually, turns out Jen and I are married. Crazy, right? How was Chicago? This is a joke, right?
No, we didn't get married. This is a big mistake. It goes way back.
Way back. Yeah, there's history here. History that you can't even begin to understand.
Don't worry, Bryce.
Let me explain. See, Jennifer and I have what's called a common law marriage.
And you've been hiding this from me?
No. Kevin dredged up this whole common law thing, and I had no idea, and I didn't think that you would understand.
You're right, I don't.
Bryce, it's just temporary, okay? I'm going to handle all of this whole thing soon enough.
Well, you better. And get rid of this parasite, or our wedding is off. Oh, and to answer your question, Chicago was great.
Oh.
Sally?
Hey, Jen. Okay, so I've been going over this crazy common law claim with everyone at the law firm, and it seems like you only have a couple of options. One, we can fight this in court, and you can spend a lot of time and a lot of money and maybe win, but even if we do win, you're not gonna get to marry Bryce anytime soon. Two, you can get Kevin to sign a document waiving any common law claim, which he won't do unless he has to, and he doesn't have to unless you make him. Look, as great of a guy as Kevin is, he's always been a quitter. If you can make Kevin's life miserable for just a few hours, show him what it means to be a real husband, I think he'll crack and sign anything.
Oh, you think? I don't know.
It'll take a day, a week tops.
I don't know.
Honey, this is the only option. In the end, Kevin will thank you, but you absolutely cannot go soft. Trust me, Kevin folds every time.
I hope so.
Okay, I'll talk to you later.
Okay, bye. morning, sweetie pie. Since you are my husband today, you get to help me do some husbandy things.
Can we revisit this in like 4 to 6 hours?
No, I'm sorry. We have a household to run.
I don't know.
These are the bills. This is a mortgage we need to refinance to get better interest rates. These are some brochures so you can call the various agents to evaluate their refi offer. These are charts for life insurance. And here is a warranty for the broken dishwasher. It may have expired, but you can handle all that, right, honey?
Can I phone in a lifeline, please? Hey, honey. Ah, so I just got done mowing the lawn, balancing the checkbook, paying our bills, and I took it upon myself to set up a SEP IRA for us.
Okay, great. Call the shop and see when my car is going to be ready, then drop off the dry cleaning, then go to the neighborhood association meeting. They need help with the bake sale. And there's a few other things on here, but don't worry. I made an hourly schedule for you.
Jan, do you want to... husband, chauffeur, or a personal assistant?
Yes. So are you ready to throw in the towel?
Oh, actually, I'm ready to step up my game.
So, how are things with Kevin?
He spent all last night working on the gazebo.
Wow, that doesn't sound at all like Kevin.
I know, I thought the same thing.
I don't know, you need to, like, raise the stakes or something. What? What's that?
Oh, Kevin! Sally and I have a few errands to run, and she's got the kids. You wouldn't mind babysitting for us, would you?
Actually, I was gonna meet the guys, shoot some hoops, you know?
Oh, that's too bad.
Yeah.
I mean, a husband has to have natural fathering instincts.
It's so important.
Very important.
It's like the most important.
The most important.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. I'm just gonna take this away from you. Let go, let go, let go, let go, let go.
Sally says you're what happens if I don't do well in school.
Oh, yeah?
You wanna fight dirty, huh?
Don't follow me. I could be wrong. It's in the air. Soon I'll be gone. Stuck here inside. These four stone walls. I'm leaving.
Do you think they killed him?
I feel kind of bad, but I'm also morbidly curious.
Well, if there's one thing those kids can do, it is crush someone's spirit.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
advice, sweetheart. Everything is moving ahead just fine. This Kevin problem will be solved shortly.
Well, I hope so. The Von Huffmans asked us to their anniversary reception this weekend at the club, and when they said, bring your fiance, it was all I could do not to blurt out she married someone else.
I'm sorry, honey.
Listen, babe, can we just talk about this later? I'm really busy right now. All right, bye.
Bye.
Kev.
Hey.
You missed another poker night.
Yeah.
Not to mention basketball today.
I know. I'm sorry, man.
What's happened to you? You never want to hang out anymore.
I got all these responsibilities now, right? I got the bills, I got the mortgage, I got the kids.
Kids? That was quick. I think you're letting this get to your head. Why are you still at this?
I don't want to let her down.
You mean you don't want her to marry Bryce?
Didn't I say that?
No.
You know, I just had this crazy idea. With all this responsibility flying around, maybe I should put away childish things and go back to school. I only need 6 more credits, right?
There you go.
I have been a little off lately, huh? Fell off the horse a bit.
You didn't just fall off. That horse knocked you down, stepped on your head, and is off eating dandelions.
How's it going with Kevin?
Kevin. Kevin has lost weight. He gets up at 5 a.m. to do his chores. The Kevin I know would have never been able to take all that.
Hang in there. I mean, he's gonna crack soon. He's got to.
Oh, it's Kevin. He's off work and my chauffeur for the day.
What?
You talking to me now?
No, I'm still mad at you. But do you think I look like a giant snowman?
Yeah. You look, beautiful. Well, I'll be in the car, my lady.
Yeah, you'll be in a men's shelter soon enough. Hey, you. Hey, sweetie.
Hi.
Looks like he hasn't slept in days. Good work, hon. You finally tighten the screws.
After everything that's happened, I can't believe you still want to marry me.
Sweetheart, of course I do.
I'm sorry. I really am, about everything.
Oh, I almost forgot. I got you a little something. You can wear it tonight at the Von Huffman's anniversary party. But Mrs. Von Huffman is head of my firm, and she adores you. I mean, can you blame her for wanting me to show you off? I got some work to finish up, and I will see you tonight at the party.
Okay.
Yeah, this is Kevin. What? Are you serious? Yeah, that's incredible. Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll see you there. Great. Bye.
Kevin?
Jen, guess what? You remember that New York investor that I was caddying for last month? Mr. Davidson? Well, he's passing through town. He wants to meet. His kid loved my game idea. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Kevin, Napoleon is sick and he's not responding.
What? Napoleon? What's wrong?
He was throwing up and now he's just laying there. I tried calling the vet, but all I got was their service. It's Bryce.
Hey, are you okay? What's wrong?
Hi. You got my message.
Yeah, what's the verdict?
He's still sick. He's laying there. I think we need to take him to the vet.
Jen, I feel terrible about it, but I'm trapped between meetings all day. I'm sure he'll be fine. Listen, babe, I gotta run. But don't be so worried about it.
He's just a dog, Jen.
We're gonna get him to the vet.
But your investor, your big opportunity.
Did I say that was today? It's tomorrow.
Kevin,
tomorrow.
Is he gonna be okay?
Napoleon had quite an intestinal blockage, but he's gonna be fine.
Oh, my goodness.
That's one of Bryce's cough balls.
I'm really sorry you missed your big meeting with Mr. Davidson.
No, I'll have more opportunities. You know, we only have one Napoleon.
Thanks, Cap.
Hey. Napoleon's gonna be fine.
No, I know. I just got really worried about the whole thing. Is my makeup, does it look okay?
Relax. You look amazing.
And you need to get some rest, Kevin. You look exhausted.
Get out of here and go have fun with Bryce.
Okay. Okay.
A husband's there when you need him.
Excuse me.
Keeps the kids occupied. Oh.
You're late.
I know. I'm sorry, okay? Napoleon, we took him. He got sick, and we had to go to the
Filming him later.
Are you angry?
I'm not angry. You're just over an hour late.
I told you, Napoleon, he
I know, but we're in ultra-critical time right now. The board meeting's next month, Jen. And when they announce partner, I'd like it to be me.
Okay. I'm sorry. I just, I've had a lot on my mind lately.
Lovely Jennifer.
It's nice to see you again, Mrs. von Hoffman.
I understand congratulations are in order. There's a wedding coming up, isn't there?
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. Jennifer, I understand you work for Monroy and Klein.
Yes, she heads up city planning.
Does she?
Yes.
You must be very talented.
Thank you.
Bryce, you're a lucky man.
Let me refresh that for you.
Yes, and would you please ask them to uncork a decent bottle this time?
Absolutely.
So you're getting married. Lucky girl. You've got your whole life ahead of you.
Yes, me and Bryce, we're really excited about the whole thing.
I wish you the best. And if Bryce steps out of line, you let me know.
Yes, I will.
Ladies.
Thank you. Cheers.
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 It was lovely talking with you.
Likewise.
Did you have a nice talk? Did she say anything about me?
No, not really.
Jenkins.
I'll be a sec.
What are you doing here?
You forgot your purse.
Thank you.
What are you doing here?
Jennifer forgot her purse. But don't worry, I'm leaving. You know what?
Ken,
I gotta say something. Jennifer here is a diamond. And you're treating her like a rhinestone.
Jennifer, get rid of him, please.
Don't talk to her that way.
Hey, Kev,
mm-hmm.
Why don't we continue this inside?
Sure, Brian.
I've had just about enough of you and all of your antics and everything.
Well, that's funny, because I've been sick of you,
now,
too.
Now, stop, you guys. This is ridiculous.
Yeah, it is ridiculous. The way this nutjob's turned our life upside down.
At least I'm not a two-faced creep.
That's it.
Bryce, oh. No!
Oh, sucker punched me.
Bryce. Oh,
you know what? You win. I mean, this is...
What?
Bryce,
stop!
Break
it
up! Get it!
Break it up!
Bryce!
Stay back! He hit me?
Bryce, are you okay?
Is he dead?
Kevin?
About how things went down. I'm sorry. Okay. Well, you're enjoying this.
Oh, so what if I am?
Come on. We've had fun over the years, right? You're my best friend, Jen.
Why put yourself through all of this?
Because you're worth it. And I think I'm falling in love with you,
Kevin.
And I don't know what to do.
Been my best friend since we were six. But Bryce, he's the one that I'm supposed to marry.
Jen. I'll sign whenever you want in the morning.
Thank you.
All right, so just sign here and then initial down there. See, Jeremy, this is called signing a document. It's what real lawyers do to actually help their clients. We do it with a pen. And then finally, this last one. And that's it. Congratulations. You are both officially not married. Not that you ever actually were in the first place.
So that's it then.
I guess so. Well, there's also the little matter of property to be returned. Ring.
Wish you and Bryce all the luck in the world.
You too.
Jennifer. Sorry for losing it the other day. You forgive me?
Well, let's just say it was less than an optimal time for the both of us.
No, I had time to think about priorities, and I realized how much you mean to me.
Well, it's done. Signed, sealed, delivered. And now we can finally focus on our wedding.
What do you keep doing?
It's just weird, not having Kevin's big ugly ring on my finger. But your ring is the only ring that I need.
And that's what I like to hear.
Drink up.
Those girls over there are checking us out.
Yeah.
You guys go talk to them.
No. Hey, what? You just gotta regroup. You gotta get back in the game.
Yeah, Kev, get out of this funk.
I'm contemplating my next move.
You still serious about going back to school?
Yeah, I wanna try something new. My notebook.
What?
My big book of my best game ideas. I left it at Jennifer's.
So go get it.
I'm not exactly welcome there anymore. I suppose maybe you could.
Sure. I'll swing by and get it.
Thank you.
And you talked to the bartenders?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I made sure all the no-name brands were banned from the bar, and the Von Hoffmans, they RSVP'd.
Perfect.
It's gonna be the wedding reception to end all wedding receptions. Though, honey. Honey.
Hmm.
I don't really know a lot of the names on this list.
Partners of the firm. His clients. Think of them as aunts and uncles you haven't met yet.
Okay. Well, if you want them there, then
Yeah, that's good for me.
Jen, you're amazing.
I just want it to be all perfect. So, do you want to come inside? We can relax and we can watch a movie.
I would love to, sweetheart, but I'm crazed. Johnson just made a play for the Marwood Tech account. I gotta go, okay?
Okay.
I love you.
Bye. Love you. Change your mind about the movie?
Hi.
Hi. Sorry, I thought you were Bryce.
Nope. Just me.
Come on in.
Thanks. So, Kevin forgot his idea book.
Oh, I know exactly where that is. I wouldn't want Kevin to lose that. That would be like Da Vinci losing his sketches. Here it is. Hey, it's a menu from Waffle Habit. Kevin and I practically lived there during college.
They had the best Belgian waffles. Do you know they closed down last year?
Yeah. Miss that place. What is it that Kevin he used to always say? He would say, don't rush through life. Stop and smell the waffles. We had some great times together, him and I.
I mean, that's my brother, right? The guy who saved your slinky? Night, Jen.
Night.
Can you believe it? The day before your wedding. We made it through this mess, and now here we are at the rehearsal.
Oh, finally. Cheers. Cheers. Ugh. You look stunning.
Mm.
Hey. Thanks.
Babe.
Oh, yeah?
Did you see the seating chart for the reception tomorrow?
Mm-hmm.
The Hatchers and Daltons are seated at the same table.
Is that a problem?
Jen, I told you, they can't sit near each other. Hatcher had Dalton tossed off his board.
Oh, I thought it was Peterson. Okay, then we'll just move them to table two.
Wait, well, table two has the chance. Hatcher's biggest competitor. Didn't you double-check this with my office?
Honey, I didn't have time. I had to dress fitting, and then we had trouble with the flowers.
It's
okay. That whole problem.
Look, I'll patch it up with Hatcher when I see him in Chicago.
You're going to Chicago again?
Yeah, I've got to. It'll just be a couple days next week. Jen, we're talking partnership here.
Our partnership or your partnership, Bryce?
You know that isn't fair.
I'm sorry, okay? I just feel like everything.
You got a lot on your plate. I'll handle the seating chart.
Jennifer, dear, if you're ready, it's time for the rehearsal.
He's just jittery, okay?
Isn't the bride supposed to be the jittery one?
So, we'll just do a quick run through and then you can go enjoy the dinner. You two aren't nervous, I hope?
Let's walk in the park, right, honey?
Then let's get started. Jennifer, I trust the rings are ready?
Yeah. But it might weigh her arm down. Like her engagement ring? Biggest rock at the jeweler's.
Jeweler's? Bryce, I thought you said this engagement ring was your grandmother's.
What?
Bryce, you said it. This engagement ring? You said that your grandfather carried it across two continents, and he would have gone further for the woman that he loved. You said that to me. I know you said that
Honey,
to me.
I took a look at my grandmother's ring, and the diamonds were just chintzy little chips. You deserve something more impressive.
As impressive as the story you told.
Okay, honey, can we not do this right
now? If you're both ready, we'll just do a brief run through of how things will go tomorrow. Everything okay?
Jennifer.
You're like the good book says, someone with a merry heart does good like medicine. Know anyone like that?
Actually, I do.
Hey, what's going on? Thank you for coming. Pleasure. And you know Jennifer? Exactly. Of course.
Bryce, who are all these people? I feel like I don't even know any of them.
Just partners at the firm who can't make the wedding tomorrow. It's fine. And Henri really outdid himself on the menu. It's going to be amazing.
Bryce. What's my favorite color?
What?
What is my favorite color?
I don't know. Blue? No, yellow. What does it matter?
For your information, it's green.
Hey, can we not do this right now?
I'm sorry.
For what?
Jennifer, what are you doing?
I should have done ages ago.
Third and main, please.
Jeremy. Kevin here. I need to find him.
He left. He's going back to school.
Where is he?
He's at the bus station. Jen! Jen, wait!
You were going away to school.
Yeah, I thought I might finish my degree.
Well, that
saying goodbye to me?
That's a local bus. I'm going to college downtown.
Of course.
Yeah.
Yeah. Kevin. I am so sorry. I'm sorry for putting you through the ringer, even though you did deserve it sometimes.
I'm sorry, too.
Even when I was trying to make you miserable this whole time, you just kept on making me happy.
I know you're not my caddy anymore, but if I'm going to invest in someone's idea, I darn well better be invited to the wedding.
Right.
I want to see that game of yours in the stores by Christmas.
Okay.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I cannot believe that you, of all people, are actually succeeding at something. It's infuriating. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Are you guys doing all right?
Yeah, since we decided to go into practice together, business is up. Admit it.
I admit it. With my courtroom experience.
And my environmental street cred.
What?
Our billable hours are up 12%. As long as your clients don't try to pay in banana bread.
Don't mock the clients. They're very committed people.
Yeah, well, I've got car payments.
Good luck.
Well?
Well? The first 7 years, Kev, they were just practice. The next seven?
Mm-hmm.
We'll get it right.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride.